Good afternoon, jury members, chairperson, and all the participants of e-conference. I am Dr. Richelina, first-year postgraduate, Department of Periodontology, Manavrishna Dental College. And today, I am presenting a review of a new technique which uses the lip furrows which are present in the lips for personal identification, which was given by author Robel K. and Raphael Dorex in 2018. So basically, in this e-poster, the strategy for the lip prints have been used for the forensic analysis. Then the lip print pattern is proposed for each individual. And instead of the photos, the lip prints were employed that were being obtained from the crime scene. For the first time, it describes the strategy as to how the lip print structure could be analyzed in the biometric applications. And further, on the basis of pattern recognition of the furrows, the identification of the person was being determined. So, starting with my presentation, in the fields of forensic and criminal investigations, the person's identification is always a challenge and can be a strenuous process. In this context, the primary evidence that can be used for DNA are the fingerprints, the teeth, and the DNA techniques. However, these methods cannot be always used because the criminals do not always leave their fingerprints behind at the crime sites. The most common sources for DNA include the blood, the semen, saliva, and the hair follicle. And the most common oral sources for DNA analysis includes the teeth, that could be the vertical or the horizontal splinting, the crushing or the grinding, and second is the saliva, which includes the whole saliva, the diluted saliva, and or the cotton swabs. And third can be the biopsy material, such as the epithelial and the connective tissue cells. Next slide. So coming to the next slide, the use of lip prints was first told by in 1932 by Edmond Locard, who was a French criminologist, and was the first person who recommended the use of lip prints. The lip prints are basically the impressions of the human lips, which are left on objects like cigarettes, glasses, drink containers, curtains, or windows. The collective name for the forensic investigation in which the human lip prints are analyzed is called as chaloscopy. The area of interest, which is focused in chaloscopy, is mainly the system of furrows, which contains many bifurcations, crossings, and other marks on the lips. The uniqueness of lip prints makes chaloscopy especially effective whenever appropriate evidence is discovered at a crime scene, be it lipstick blot marks or lip prints left on the cups, glasses, or even on the envelopes. Next slide. So the surface of the lips is covered by numerous reticular depressions, which are known as furrows, that form a system of lines. It contains on an average 1,145 individual features, forming a unique pattern different for each person, be it female or male. This number is very large when it is compared with that of the fingerprints. In 1967, Santos was the first person to classify the lip grooves, in which he classified it as straight line, curved line, angled line, or the sine-shaped line. Then the classification for lip grooves was also given by Suzuki and Shushihashi, which is also known as the Shushihashi classification system, which included the complete straight groove, the partial straight groove, the branch groove, the intersected, the reticular, and the undifferentiated grooves. So coming to the stages of lip printing, in forensic laboratories, lip prints are transferred with the help of, first, there'll be application of the moisturizing cream. Then in the second step, the white paper is being rolled over in the lip. And thirdly, the magnetic powder is being used and the magnetic powder applicator is being used. And forensic analysis focuses on the location and the inclination of the furrows which are occurring on a lip print pattern. Finally, the image of the print appearing on the paper is then converted into the digital image of a scanner. Coming to the proposed method, first is the LibPrint preparation. In the LibPrint preparation, it takes place with the use of a white paper roller, magnetic powder, and magnetic powder applicator. As I have told before, the leaf prints will be are taken from each person, and all the prints are collected on a sheet of a paper having the same dimension, and then they are being scanned. Previous slide, please. And centered so that the location within the image is uniform. Previous slide, ma'am. Second step is the separation of the upper and the lower lip. The division of the lips is carried out by adding a curve in the image running between the lips. The part of the lip above the curve is the upper lip and remaining is the lower lip. So basically the polynomial approximation is done for separation, which gave better results and was 65% faster. In the lip, lip separation, the separation was subjected to binarization and dilatation. The binarization was done with the help of autosomatic selection of the binarization threshold. Coming to the extraction of the furrows, firstly, only the selected part, that is either the upper lip or the lower lip, is proposed. The analyzed image is then was then shifted to a white background and then centered. Then there was normalization was done by stretching the image's histogram. And then the image that was formed was filtered with the help of Gaussian convolution filter to strengthen the furrows. Coming to the parameterization, the identification based on the patterns of the furrows had many patterns like lines and dots. Lines were the frequent pattern that was used. Thus, there was analysis of the straight lines from which the lip patterns were formed. Then there was lip pattern creation. Here there was preparation with the help of a set of lip prints that contains the images of the lips belonging to the person for whom the pattern is created. So based on the obtained set, matrix is created and the lip patterns were formed. So in the user identity, so basically for this purpose of printing, Seikonovsky coefficient was used, which allows for comparison of two sets which contains different amounts of data. And the resulting image was divided into the upper and lower lips, and then it was parameterized, and two sets of lip containing the furrows were obtained. Next slide. So coming to the final conclusion step, it was being seen that this method enabled an effective identification for person based on the lip prints, and the best identification accuracy was obtained for about like 97.2%, and identification results were seen by the use of 15 furrows on each lip pattern, that is either the upper lip or the lower lip. Both had 15 furrows were being used. And the lip prints at the scene of crime can be a basis for various objectives, such as the character of the event, the sex that is involved, the number of people involved, etc. And the lip print pattern had helped and accelerated and facilitated the forensic technicians' work.